Hello, boys and girls, and welcome to today's version of Number Corner, which is the last day for our April Number Corner videos, okay? Because then we're into May. Today is April the 29th, and today you guys are going to be expected to do some independent workbook pages in your Number Corner book. So while we're talking and before we get started, you may want to go ahead and get that out. I will show you what today's calendar marker looks like, and just to go ahead, because we won't be in school tomorrow, we'll also show you what the 30th's calendar marker looks like. And I want to quickly review that we've talked about lots of geometric terms this month. We've named polygons, we've talked about regular polygons, irregular polygons. A regular polygon, all sides are equal. Irregular may look something like this. But yet it's still a pentagon. It just doesn't look like the house that we are used to seeing. We've talked about symmetry, when you can fold something in half and it matches exactly the same. It's like a mirrored image, if you will. We've talked about equilateral. We've talked about isosceles. And we've talked about scalene. Isosceles triangles have two sides that are equal, and we could see that here from the 22nd. And then scalene, all sides are different, which we just reviewed, I believe, yesterday. We've also had problems where they show us a shape, and they tell us the area, and we have to figure out what the other dimension is before we can solve for the perimeter. And that's kind of going to be what you guys are going to be working on independently today in your workbook. Let's focus on the 26th marker for just a second, just to quickly review, because I don't know if we talked about this specifically on Monday. We know this side is 10, and we know the inside, or the area, is 50 square centimeters. We have to figure out this other dimension. So the question would be, what times 10 gives you 50? And I'm hoping that you're thinking 5. 10 times 5 is indeed 50. Which means my perimeter, I can now find. 10 plus 10 is 20, plus 5 plus 5 would be 30 centimeters for my perimeter. We've gotten equilateral triangles where we've only been given one side, and we know the perimeter because we know what equilateral means. So keep those things in mind when you get to work on your workbook page today. Okay, we're also gonna, so we have two workbook pages. The first one is focused on perimeter and area, much like we've done with our calendar grid. So kind of wrapping up what we know to be true from doing that this month. So that is on page 78. So go ahead and open up and get there. We will do one example together, and then you will be expected to do this independently. Okay, so let's look at the first one. It says find the area of these two rectangles. Well, luckily, we know area means we have to multiply. So it looks like we're multiplying 4 times 7.5. Okay, now don't be discouraged because you see a mixed number here, because there's two different ways we could solve it. We could think about it as 4. Let me put some parentheses here. 4 times 7 plus 4 times a half. We could think about it like that, and that's essentially us using the distributive property, because maybe, just maybe, I separate this side into 7 and then a half. Okay? And we could do that easily. 4 times 7, we know, is 28. And then 4 times a half. That means if I have a half 4 times, a half plus a half plus a half plus a half. 2 halves equal a whole. So now I have 2 wholes. 28 plus 2 will give you 30. That's one way that you could have solved this problem. The other way that you could solve it, and the reason I'm going over that is because it looks like you have another problem here that has a mixed number. Is since we have 4 times 7.5, that means I could essentially add 7.5 4 times. 7.5 plus 7.5 plus 7.5. And so that's the other way that I could have solved this problem. And here you can clearly see the seven, the four sevens, and then the four halves, a half plus a half plus a half plus a half. So you're going to be doing that for this next problem here. And I do want to label that because area is square units, and in this case, it's square centimeters. Let's see. For number two, you're finding the perimeter, but we only know one side. So you got to do some division. 56 divided by 7 would give you this other dimension. Or you can think 7 times something is 56 centimeters. And the last question is asking you to draw some isosceles triangles. Remember, isosceles, two sides are the same. Okay? And they want a perimeter of 26, so you can be a little creative. So that's assignment number one. Assignment number two is on page 80. So if you flip the page, you should see it. And it's all about what we've done for our calendar collector with decimeters and centimeters. And you should be able to fill this out fairly easy because looks like down here we're counting by tens, 50, 60, 70, 80. And up here we're counting by ones because in each decimeter there are 10 centimeters. And then there's some questions for you down here to solve as well. So here is me telling you good luck because you need to be able to work on this independently since we've been doing it all month essentially. So now's your chance to show me that not only have you been paying attention, but you've been thinking about what we've been talking about. You've processed it, and now you can show that you have learned the information. So good luck, and perhaps I will see you in May. Bye-bye.